9 chemistry will start with the incomplete combustion, and actually the process of incomplete combustion, respiration also a slow combustion process, and also the differentiation between combustion and respiration, and also what are the disadvantages of incomplete combustion. So today we will start with the incomplete combustion.
So we will start with the incomplete combustion, that is burning of combustible substances in the presence of limited amount of the supporter of combustion is commonly called the incomplete combustion or partial combustion. If we see the example that when carbon is burned in the presence of limited amount of oxygen, it is called incomplete combustion, and carbon during this incomplete combustion produces carbon monoxide. If we see the reaction that C plus O2 change into CO2, that is heat plus light, complete combustion. Incomplete combustion, if we see that 2C plus O2 change into 2CO plus heat plus light. So thus when any carbon containing combustible substance undergoes combustion in the presence of limited air or oxygen, it undergoes partial combustion producing CO, CO2 and unburned carbon particle. Now what are the disadvantages of incomplete combustion? If we see that incomplete combustion is actually problematic because during incomplete combustion both carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide are produced. Carbon monoxide is highly poisonous pollutant. If inhaled, it can cause death. During incomplete combustion, the heat produced is less than that of produced during complete combustion. So incomplete combustion leads to higher consumption of fuel, combustible material, if we see. So sometimes incomplete combustion leads to the formation of unburned carbon particle. This unburned carbon particle make the flame sooty and smoky. So now move on to the another topic, that is what is the why the respiration called the slow combustion. You have seen that during respiration, the carbon containing compound react with oxygen to form CO2 and H2O, and energy is released. CO2, H2O energy are also be product of combustion. This shows that respiration is similar to combustion, but respiration takes place slowly at body temperature. Therefore, respiration is called slow combustion. Respiration is also called the spontaneous combustion. Now move on to the another topic, that is how combustion differ from the respiration. If we see that combustion is a fast process, always combustion is a fast process, whereas in case of respiration is a slow process. Combustion starts only when combustible material is heated to the ignition temperature. Respiration takes place at body temperature, that is 37 degree centigrade. Therefore no preheating is needed. In case of combustion, liberation of heat during combustion is very rapid. It raises temperature of burning material. Heat is released so slowly that it is lost to the surrounding, and temperature of the body remains virtually unchanged. Combustion is accompanied by flame and smoke, whereas no flame and smoke is seen during respiration. Combustion of any combustible material takes place outside the body of human being or any animal. Respiration takes place inside the body of human being. Now another also how this respiration resemble with the combustion. The respiration like combustion involve reaction of combustible material with oxygen, and the product of respiration and that combustion are the same, and that is CO2, H2O and heat energy. Now if you see the comparison between the nature of reaction, that is oxidation, also the temperature is combustion high, respiration body temperature is low, rate of process is fast actually, in case of respiration is slow. And depends on condition that both produce CO2, H2O, heat and light, but here actually in respiration only CO2 and H2O. Another point is that change of mass is also found in case of burning, that when substance is burned, the substance combines with oxygen to give one or more product. The experiment that carried out product are collected and weighs, then the total mass of all the product will be greater than the mass of the substance burned. So here also one example also be there, that if we burn the magnesium, then it actually change into MgO. Actually it gain the mass. So from that also we can tell that change of mass in burning takes place. So today up to that, next we will start with another topic.